I'm here with Dr. Jon Stokes, Assistant Professor of Biochemistry and Biomedical Sciences at McMaster University. Thank you for joining me today, Dr. Stokes.
Thank you for having me.
Artificial intelligence, or AI, is an incredibly powerful tool. In what way has it transformed the landscape of health research?
That's a good question. In the context of health research, I think we can break the use of AI into two general categories, one being, you know, preclinical discovery, and the second one being clinical discovery slash clinical application. So in the context of preclinical discovery, AI has been used for a diverse array of tasks. These can be things like molecular property prediction, you know, doing new drug discovery, protein structure prediction, protein function prediction, even things like predicting the evolutionary trajectories of viral pathogens like SARS-CoV-2. Now, in the context of clinical application, AI is being used to, for example, maximize data extraction from sources like electronic medical records. These can be things like, you know, chest x-rays, mammograms, et cetera. And in this domain, AI is helping increase the capacity, let's say, for healthcare providers to make optimal clinical decisions.
Why is AI and machine learning so valuable in the process of discovering new antibiotics?
In the antibiotic space currently, we find ourselves in this really unfortunate scenario where we have an alarmingly lean, like a really, really lean antibiotic pipeline and global dissemination of antibiotic resistance. And what that means is it's becoming really difficult to treat many types of bacterial infections that were once, you know, relatively trivial to treat. As soon as we begin to implement a new antibiotic in the clinic, we start selecting for resistance. In an ideal world, we would be able to invent new antibiotics faster than resistance can evolve in the clinic. And it's my opinion and the opinion of my students that AI can help us realize this ideal case by increasing the rate at which we can discover novel chemical matter with antibacterial properties, but also novel chemical matter that is inherently safe for humans, right? Because you have to think, when we're developing a new medicine, it has to do the biological thing you want it to do and be well tolerated by your patients.
How do you see the use of AI in healthcare evolving over the next 5 years?
That's a really good question, and I don't know. It's one of these instances where the field is moving at such a high rate to try to predict what development is coming and indeed what the downstream application of those developments will be. It's not trivial, but at a very high level, you know, something that I am confident about, like these AI systems will continue to improve as increasing quantities of high quality data are curated and used to train all of these models.
That's terrific. Thank you so much, Dr. Stokes. As you've shared, the future of AI holds immense potential. And it's great to see how you and your team have embraced its power to accelerate discoveries. Thanks so much for joining me today.
Thank you.